The Marigold Hotel has been going properly for 8 months now. People who come and go, but there's been a core of regulars from the beginning. Whoa!
The story begins with a pitch to an American company that deals in things to do with retirement.
Let me do the talking.
And Sonny, who is a blue sky thinker, is determined to see whether he can't franchise this idea.
And we become the furthest outpost of the Evergreen franchise.
Let me say, right here.
And so the story people would expect to begin in India actually begins in California.
Why die here when I can die there?
A lot's happened since Marigold One.
I'm out of a wheelchair, which is good.
I think it's quite surprising all round. Everybody's little stories intertwine.
Basically, Sunny is getting married.
But because Sunny is Sunny, there's always these last-minute hurdles.
He's getting married. The hotel needs to be expanded, and then...
How's America?
Kushal!
Sunny is insecure about my brother's friend.
So Sunny's journey is trying to find his confidence in his life.
You're screwing up, Sunny boy. I'm like a kind of grandmother to Sunny. And I think in the first film I saw a lot of potential in him, and in this one it's lovely to see him grow.
It takes the story on, and we have this wonderful injection too of Tamsin Greig and Richard Gere.
Lord have mercy on my ovaries.
First time in India?
No, it's just pretty much a dream until now.
Any other dreams I could help you with?
This is actually a much more Shakespearean story of comedy and manners and human foibles. And I think focusing on the younger couple much more in this movie has added a lot to it and allows all the characters with their middle age problems to kind of bounce around.
You should marry that girl.
I want to.
Well, that's been going on for some time.
Douglas and Evelyn, they've made a connection, and it seems logical at least one of them should be tentative about confirming that connection. And in this case, it's Evelyn.
I don't know if I'm excited or terrified.
And Douglas is confused, I think.
It's a given of this material that everybody's life crosses with everybody else's life because they physically meet all the time. And when you're thinking about continuing the story, the opportunities that that presents is very interesting.
Sometimes it seems to me that the difference between what we want and what we fear is the width of an eyelash.
I'm so sorry, were you talking to me?
I don't know why I tell you anything.
Because I'm older and wiser.
19 days older.
That's the entire lifespan of a wasp.
Hello, Valerie here. Now, what would be your answer if I asked you what the worst film of all time was? What, do you know? Okay, I'll tell you. The film Disaster Movie is officially the worst film of all time. This is according to reviews and opinion polls on IMDb, averaging just a 1.3 out of 10 rating on IMDb and a 2% on Rotten Tomatoes. Haven't seen it? I wouldn't bother. Unless you want to see just how bad it is, then go ahead. Download our Film Is Now app, available for both Android and iOS.